Well, gentlemen, mass flow is what our technology measures, mass flow rate of gases. And why is mass flow so important? Mass flow is important because when you're dealing with a process, it's generally the mass flow you're looking for. For example, batching. You need to know how many grams or grams per minute. Batching relates to the mass. What about breathing, if you're measuring your oxygen? It's the molecules that really matter. It's not just the volume, it's the molecules. A chemical process, it's a chemical reaction, that's molecular. There are industry requirements to measure efficiencies. Well, that often is BTUs. Well, it relates to combustion control. You might need to measure the natural gas in the air to get the proper air-fuel ratio. Again, it's molecules. I can go on and on, but eventually you need to measure mass flow. And there's only one other technology that measures mass flow, and it's Coriolis. Now, it used to be just for liquids. Coriolis now can measure gases, particularly at higher pressures. They have issues we'll talk about. They don't handle... you might have to size down a Coriolis to get the sensitivity. 4-inch line might need a 2-inch Coriolis. But Coriolis and thermal mass flow meters are mass flow devices, and everything else are not. Which means when we cover the competition section, your orifice plate needs a temperature and pressure correction. Your turbine meter needs a temperature and pressure correction. Your Venturis, your differential pressures, other devices, your multi-point annulars, all of those. Roots meters, temperature and pressure. We don't need that because we're inherently measuring the mass flow.